Hi, hello, and 안녕하세요. My name is Lee, and welcome to my channel. Today, I will be reviewing and discussing the South Korean queer film White Knight.
6시까지만 다시는 한국 안 올 거거든. 뭔데?
White Knight is a drama that follows Wong-gyu, an airline steward who returns to Korea after a traumatic event 2 years ago sent him abroad. On his one-day layover, he hooks up with a courier named Tae-jun and attempts to sort through his past across the streets of Seoul. Released in 2012, White Knight is the third feature film from director Lee Sung-hee. It made its world premiere in April of that year at the 13th Jeonju International Film Festival, after which it was invited to numerous other international and queer-focused film festivals, including having its European debut at the Berlin International Film Festival. The film was released to extremely limited theaters for the domestic audience beginning November 15th. The drama went on to gross $39,227, according to the Business Zone of the Korean Film Council. Its theatrical run ended with an estimated 6,694 admissions. Unfortunately, before I review the film, there is an aspect of this director's background I must include. In 2018, he was accused by another male director of sexual harassment at a short film festival. Lee did admit the truth of the accusation, and if you'd like further details, I provided a link to an article in the description box below. Having acknowledged the director's misconduct, I do still want to discuss White Knight. When reading the sparse viewer responses on this film, most criticized the plot as confusing or hard to follow. In addition, a review from Variety called the film pretentious and disliked its execution. While I do not agree, I will provide a little more detail as well as my critique. Our protagonist, Wong-gyu, works for a German airline and flies into Korea for one night. Through an app or website, he coordinates a hookup with Tae-jun, a motorcycle courier, but what begins as an intended casual sexual encounter is soon complicated by Wong-gyu's volatile moods and unresolved past. Cinematographer Yoon Ji-eun shoots White Knight against Seoul's urban landscape and utilizes close-ups to capture the interiority of characters who are very emotionally guarded. Both Won Tae-hee and Lee Kyung are effective in relating a dynamic that is both ephemeral yet meaningful, wary yet reactionary. Tonally, the film seethes with frustration and clear nuances of rage. More on that later. Lee Sung is an openly gay filmmaker, one of the few working in South Korea, although he has not made a film since 2016. As a result, the film apprehends the kind of existential rage that can come with being a sexual minority, or a minority generally, in a culture determined to marginalize you. Common questions surface like, why is society like this? Why must I live like this? The unfairness, the injustice, the hiding, the shaming, the hostility. The spiritual and physical scars of living in a country, society, and culture that alienates, that does not accept, and that hurts you run deep. That kind of rage unique to minority experience could be difficult to conceptualize or otherwise capture by a majority director. While there is sexual content in this film, if I had to provide trigger warnings without direct spoilers, it would include some violence, trauma, and other sensitive subject matter, such as homophobia, hate crimes, and public outing. Altogether, I would give White Knight an A. At 75 minutes, White Knight is an extremely tight film, which complements its all-in-one-night narrative structure. The story shows what the psychological impact of a past trauma that is directly sourced from queer experiences can look and feel like. Significantly, it was the rage that caught me upon viewing. It feels both distinctively queer and highly personal, a unique occurrence in South Korean film. As Wong-gyu's story unfolds, and the understanding between the two men shifts, it proves a very compelling watch. Although White Knight is difficult to access for personal viewing, please check it out. Until next time, goodbye farewell and 안녕히 계세요.